Christy Kinsey with Landmark Tax and Investment Services. So tax season is right around the corner, and there are a lot of changes to the 2018 tax season. So today I'm going to talk about qualified business income deduction. Now, figuring this deduction can be very complicated, so I'm going to touch on some key points. The main people that this is available to is individuals if their return includes income from sole proprietor, partnership, or S-Corp. There's a few others, but we're not going to touch on them, just the main ones. This is not an adjusted gross income deduction, but a below-the-line deduction, and I'll explain what that means in a little bit. So qualified business income is defined as the taxpayer's profit or loss from each trade or business. Qualified business income does not include W-2 wages, no matter where the wages are from. So it's, if they're from your business, it does not include them. Congress decided to exclude certain high-income taxpayers from this deduction. So the taxpayer's business is in the field of health, law, accounting, actual science, performing arts, consulting, and it also includes athletics, financial services, and brokerage services. It does not include real estate brokers. They can take this full deduction as long as their taxable income is under the threshold amount. If it is above the threshold amount, but below the ceiling amount, then they will get a partial deduction. Once it is above the ceiling, there isn't a deduction. There are special rules for figuring the partial deduction. It's a little bit more complicated to figure out this. It's just not cut and dry, and it's limited by your taxable income. So, Christy Kinsey, Landmark Tax and Investment Services, and thank you for watching.